As we're just waiting on everyone to finish uploading, and there we go. Okay, so spawning in the top left-hand corner as the red Protoss, it is Kirda. And then his opponent spawning in the bottom right-hand corner as the pink Protoss, it is Boost. So with a against a PvP map, we do normally see it's either going to be a 3-gate Robo or a 4-gate. It is normal build that we do see when we do see two Protosses against each other. So we see a pylon going down for Kirda, and then it's exactly the same for Boost. As pretty much it's just drone period, we will probably with both people putting their pylons there, we will see a gateway coming down next. So we do see the scout coming down for Kirda. Just going to have a look around, check if see what timing that Boost is going to take his gas, because by the timing of gas, a Protoss player can normally tell what kind of build they are doing. As you do see Boost laying down his gateway and then going for the scout, and we see exactly the same for Kirda. We do see the gateway going down, and we'll probably see the gas being taken around about soon. It's only about 15 that we see the gas come down, as there goes Boost, and yeah, there goes Kirda. So it's pretty much standard opers, they are doing exactly the same as each other. As we do see now, Boost probe coming in the base, he will scout that they have taken their gas, and it is about the same timing as his own gas. So he's just going to stand, putting it on patrol, just so he can keep an eye on what's happening. There we see Cybernet is coming down for Kirda. We do see another pylon coming down. We just take a look in Boost base. See him just attacking the probe at the moment, but we do see him putting his cybernetics, and he already does have two pylons down. So he's just currently boosting his probes at the moment, trying to get as many probes out as he can, try and get maxed out on probes before too late, so he does have that good mineral income. So we do see Kirda trying to attack Boost probes, but he's just putting it on a wider patrol, so won't really get attacked that much. We do see the chrono boost of the cybernetics coming out now, and we do see Kirda just going to put two more gateways down. We do see on Boost, we do see a stalker in production, and we do see the chrono boost coming out. We do see another pylon coming out for Boost as he is getting close to his supply cap, so that is good to see. Players putting it down two before they reach the supply limit. So we do see, as Boost has just scouted, the second gas is on its way out, so I would expect to see Robo. He's going straight for an expansion, so it is going to be an expansion at about 5 minutes for Kirda. If you just take a look at Boost, we do see a pylon coming down at the main ramp here. We do see another Zucker being produced, and he's just mainly kind of boosting his Nexus just to get as many probes out as possible, as we are probably going to see an expansion from him, and yes we do. So this is pretty much a 1-gate expand against a 3-gate. Oh no, he cancelled his expansion. So that might just, he might just been thinking, if he does get scouted, it looks like he's going for an expansion. But now he's going to come up the ramp, see these two stalkers, and there he goes. As now Boost automatically goes out and sees if there's any proxies. As no, he actually goes for his Nexus again, so he might have, a bit weird why he cancelled it in the first place if he was going to go for another Nexus. But we do see Nexus coming out, and we do see him putting the pylon down as his Vortech did finish up. Nice positioning of his stalker on his Zanaga, and from boost we do see he has two on the Zanaga, so he gets good vision on seeing what is incoming, and that is always good to see. And we do see another gateway being produced. His warp gate is up, as there he goes. So saying that, he does actually change him into warp gate. So we do see he is going to be a free gate robo out of boost, as that was a massive drone transfer. So that was really good to see. He was just maxing out on drones on his main base. So when his second base was ready, he had a lot to transfer. And that is a lot of drones already on a second base. So now we do see the sentry is out. We do see he does have three stalkers on the field. Let's just look at drone count. Yeah, if you look at the drone count, Kirda is on 28 probes, 4 stalkers and 3 sentries, compared to Boost, 35 probes, 3 stalkers and then 1 sentry. So it's in head, as Boost has actually not set a waypoint to that, as he has just noticed. So it's nice spread by Kirda with the stalkers at the top of the ramp to just force field the ramp if there is any aggression coming on, and the three stalkers there just to put up the damage. So now we do see the first observer is being pumped out, and we do see the chrono boost got on the blink, so he's trying to get this blink tech out as fast as possible. So I was looking around, we do see two more pylons coming, actually three more pylons coming down. Ah, hidden one. Three pylons coming down for Boost at the moment. We do see that his first immortal is actually on the field. We do see that he does have a Twilight Council just being built, and he has his own observer coming out. And we've got a nice little push coming down from Kirda. He has got six stalkers and 4 sentries and 1 zealot just pushing down the field. We do see that he's going to put a proxy pylon just where Boost 4th would probably be, but with this army he won't do that much aggression unless he does take down these rocks and without Boost actually seeing it. So just do switch to Boost. Yeah, he does have a good vision of the rocks, as he did just take the observer down. But that is a quite nice little army. He does have the zealots, but I would like to see the zealots in front of the ramp, in front of the rest of the army, just so they don't get blocked. Just looking. Yeah, we do see as a really nice position observer by Boost. We do see he does scout that he has got immortals, and he's not really building much behind all of this. As we do see, he is going to attack the rocks, but Boost, if he's got sound on, he should notice they are coming in, unless he's not trying to draw attention that he knows. As he does see Scout, he does try and push back with a few stalkers. But a really bad position with his zealots behind his main army. He needs to put the zealots in front because they will be the meat shield and they will do quite a bit of damage. Just standing like that, as you do see, not really does any damage. Nice force field and nice guardian shield by Kirda himself, just saving these two stalkers that he has with low damage. So Kirda just moves a bit back, probably thinking it's probably not that good for him to engage at the moment, as Boost does have quite a big army and he's in head on supply, as Kirda actually supply blocks himself, as he does lay two more gateways down and one more pylon. I would like to see a couple more pylons down, because one warp in and he'll be back to supply blocked. As we do see, just trying to find, here's a Templar. Ah, he does have Templar archives being built. As he is producing another observer, seems his last one did get killed. Oh, and Boost pulls out the wrong way. If I was Boost, I would have carried on that way around, engaged from the side, because Kirda would have not really noticed that. So we are seeing storm in production by Kirda and a warp prism. So are we going to see drop storm play on the mineral line? Because there's two storms and they're pretty much gone. And it's really nice positioning by boosting in this case, but nice force field stopping the front lot of immortals going pretty much anywhere. And yeah, he didn't. Let's just have a look. Yeah, he hasn't really lost that many units compared to Kirda, as we do see Kirda just moving back now because he has lost a lot of his units. We do see that he is now taking his third, it is nearly done, with two pylons in front. But with these forces, I would see him like to take down the rock so he has easy access. But that is a big push coming up from Boost now. This army versus that army. Yeah, I would say he has not much of a chance, really. So you do see, he is going to push for that third base. He's going to, like, boom, cheat, destroy it. So Kirda really just needs to actually pull back, do not engage the sun, because he will lose too much. And he just gets that kill quite quickly on the Nexus. Let's see how fast he drops him down. Wow. Them rocks went down very fast. As now we do see the push coming up from Boost. He does need to move up as far up the ramp as he can, so the back units do get a good... Wow. And GG goes down.